Plants in the landscape fill important psychological needs. For example, the color green has a calming effect on people. In large cities, no green spaces lead to stress in humans. Living plants promote human health and help to overcome the stress of everyday living. So the need for attractive landscapes is increasing continually. I'm Dr. DeBosca, and in this video, I'll discuss the reasons why people landscape and the principles and elements of landscape design. Landscaping's most common use is to create an aesthetically pleasing outside environment for both homeowners and businesses. Landscaping definitely creates a more beautiful environment that can be enjoyed by homeowners and by the public in parks and horticultural gardens. But those are not the only purposes for landscaping. Landscaping can dramatically enhance the property value in a specific neighborhood. Landscaping can be used to reduce noise from factories, highways, and other sources because plants buffer noise. Landscaping helps buildings and other structures blend into the terrain. At many universities, any new building that goes up is not allowed to affect how the campus looks. Landscaping can be used to screen unsightly areas by providing a beautiful plant wall around dumpsters, storage areas, and other unsightly areas. Landscaping provides privacy in backyards of homes or shields private business locations from the general public. Landscaping prevents erosion to improve and conserve natural resources and reduces pollution to increase the quality of human life. Landscaping can be used to control people traffic and vehicle traffic. Barberry bushes have sharp thorns which deter people from taking a shortcut through private property or through a location where they should not be walking. Landscape can reduce damage and injury. For example, shrubs along a roadway can absorb shock in an automobile crash. Landscaping can be broken down into several categories: home landscaping, public area landscaping such as parks, commercial landscaping, specialty site landscaping such as zoos. Home landscaping is typically up to the individual homeowner. However, in some cases, developers establish a theme for a given development and landscape the area based on that particular theme. Landscaping public areas such as parks is done for a variety of reasons. For example, small parks can be put at strategic locations in the city to provide a place for workers to rest on their lunch hour. On a community level, parks are landscaped for specific purposes, such as parks with baseball fields, tennis courts, running trails, and other recreational facilities. On national or state levels, parks may be used to preserve wildlife while providing recreation areas. Commercial landscaping is done at shopping malls, banks, churches, restaurants, and other places. Commercial landscaping should be functional and safe. Specialty landscaping includes gardens and zoos or botanical gardens, where special designs are used to establish a specific habitat, or a golf course where landscaping is used to provide obstacles for the game and aesthetic beauty. For a landscape to be successful, it must start with a well-conceived design, followed by the proper installation and maintenance. The landscape architect establishes design plan for plants and hardscaping features such as pools and patios. The landscape architect discusses the client's desires, implements a site plan and planting plan for a given location, which provides detailed guidelines on how to install the landscape, and oversees the project until completion. A site plan is a drawing indicating the location of plants and hardscaping objects in the landscape. The planting plan is a drawing that uses symbols to specify the types and names of plants, their quantities, and their locations in the landscape. The landscape contractor implements the planting plan and maintains the landscape. For a landscape design to be successful, it must include considerations of the plant's features. Color is a design element that people respond to in different ways and should be used carefully to produce a successful design. Different colors elicit different responses. For example, reds, yellows, and oranges give the feeling of warmth and the appearance of coming toward the viewer, whereas blues and greens give a cool feeling and appear to the viewer as if they are in the background. Sources of color in the landscape are flowers, green variegated or seasonal leaves, and the bark on trees. These sources provide the landscape designer with a wide variety of options. Texture is another design element and refers to the visual and physical characteristics of a plant. The physical texture characteristics can be felt by the sense of touch, whereas the visual surface characteristics can project different images to the individual looking at the landscape, because such characteristics can create a very smooth or a coarse feeling. When seasons change, so do a variety of textures. For example, when a deciduous tree has leaves, the tree provides a smooth texture, but when the leaves fall off, the tree provides a coarse texture. The bark of trees also varies in texture, with some being very smooth, and others being very coarse, such as oak. or the bark may have a peeling appearance, such as birch. Different textures can be incorporated into the landscape by using inanimate objects such as mulch, stones, gravel, brick, and others. The distance of the viewer from the landscape can visually modify how coarse an object appears. The greater the distance, the less coarse an object will appear. There should be no abrupt changes from coarse to fine textures in a landscape. Form is a three-dimensional element. For example, a tree shape can be round, weeping, horizontal, and a variety of other shapes. Form provides another element whereby the designer can produce an interesting landscape design. Line is the one-dimensional effect produced by arranging three-dimensional objects in a certain way. Line is a design tool that the landscape architect uses to create and control patterns in the landscape. Formal straight lines are found in pavement design, and to keep them from being monotonous, pavement elements such as bricks can be arranged to soften the effects of straight lines. The arrangement of landscape objects in a line can be used to direct viewers to the focal point in the design. Lines do not have to be straight, and when they are straight, they do not have to be continuous. The landscape designer can introduce breaks in the line to cause the viewer to either pause or change views. Lines can be contoured or curvilinear to slow down viewing and manipulate the viewer to spend more time to appreciate the particular portion of the landscape. The principles of design help landscape architects develop good designs that are economical to install and easy to maintain. Simplicity is a landscape design principle that uses a number of strategies to reduce high levels of variation and general distractions in the landscape. The landscape architect should use simplicity, which basically means not being overly complex in a given design, thereby promoting overall unity. Balance is a landscape design principle that uses equal weight of the elements of design to show uniformity. Balance can be symmetrical balance, where the same number and types of plants are on both sides of a landscape. Another type of balance is asymmetrical balance, which is when different numbers of plants are on both sides of a landscape. Proportion is the landscape design principle that refers to the relationship between the sizes of the different types of plants used in a landscape design. Proportion is not only used with respect to the plants in the landscape, but also with respect to their relationship with inanimate objects in the landscape. For example, large trees should not overshadow a small house. Focalization is a landscape design principle that creates an accent in a particular arrangement. The landscape architect creates focal points in the landscape to direct where people look. Focalization is a very effective way to guide the viewer to areas in the landscape that the landscape architect does not want them to miss, such as fountains, sculptures, and exotic plants. Another reason for the use of focalization is to redirect the viewer's attention from an unattractive location in the landscape. Rhythm and line is the landscape design principle that deals with flow throughout the landscape. Different sections in the landscape must be linked to create movement throughout the design. Planting bed shape, bed orientation, and heights and shapes of plant materials and inanimate objects in the landscape have a profound effect on rhythm and line. All parts of the landscape, including the landscape wall, ceiling, and floor, must fit together without being forced. In conclusion, you now have a basic knowledge of the elements and principles of landscape design. There are many practical reasons for landscaping in both corporate and residential settings.